Great, thank you. I love public speaking, and I love following one of the highest rated TED speakers on the website, so I'm super excited to go next. What I want to talk about today is kind of some of the stuff that my company, DigitalOcean, has done to build our version of what we think is a learning organization, in terms of some of the things that we've done from our culture side and using a lot of the tools and systems of some of the folks represented here today. So, I don't know how many of you have heard of DigitalOcean. If you're a developer, you definitely have. We are one of the fastest growing companies, fastest growing startups in New York, and we're one of the fastest growing cloud infrastructure companies, and we specifically work on creating really simple, easy to use, high capacity cloud systems for developers. And so you can see the stats. We've been around 4 years. We've been pretty successful from a business perspective. We've been pretty successful from an employee perspective. We are not the top bar, that would be Amazon, but we're number two, and we're growing fast, and that's actually pretty good for kind of where we are as a pure play cloud infrastructure provider. So it's a really great business story, which is a really nice baseline to start from. And with rapid business growth means that you've got to build an organization to grow with it. And one of the interesting things about us as a company is, even early on in our life cycle, we were a fairly successful business. So our revenue model, our business model was really, really good. And then the challenge that comes with that is that you need to scale the organization to match the speed and the pace and the scale of the business. So while that's a nice problem to have, it does create its own kind of unique challenges. And one of the things that we really wanted to focus on, one of the things that we really wanted to be intentional of, is how we create an organization that's going to deliver on the promise of the business and feel true to some of the things that we and the founders care about, which is creating, of course, a learning organization. And so you can see that we scaled very rapidly, doubling in size over the past year. We actually expect that pace to accelerate over the next year. So the slope is going to be even bigger. So lots of work for people to match this speed and the pace and the scale of the business. So while that's a nice problem to have, it does create its own kind of unique challenges. And one of the things that we really wanted to focus on, one of the things that we really wanted to be intentional of, is how we create an organization that's going to deliver on the promise of the business and feel true to some of the things that we and the founders care about, which is creating, of course, a learning organization. And so you can see that we scaled very rapidly, doubling in size over the past year. We actually expect that pace to accelerate over the next year. So the slope is going to be even bigger. So lots of work for people to do. One of the ways in which we built a people organization, and a bunch of them are here, and even if they weren't, I would say this, we have one of the, if not the best people teams in the entire Silicon Valley. It's an amazing team. And we structured it in a way to support the rapid growth of the business, and we structured it in a way to support the rapid growth of the organization. And so we have four areas that we focus on. And what's really critical, even though I'm talking today about really kind of the learning side and the talent development side, is to really be effective, these parts all need to work together, right? And so we have a talent development function, we have a standard kind of talent acquisition recruiting function, we have a team that focuses on some of the more operational aspects of the people side, and we have a team that focuses on creating an amazing employee experience. What really makes a team work together is how much these intersect and how well the team works together. So, you know, it's great to hire lots of people, and we have a great recruiting team, and we hire lots of people really quickly, but if you can't successfully onboard them, if you can't set them up for success and grow them in the organization and do things on the talent development side, well, then you're missing out. You can't create an amazing experience that's going to make them love coming to work every day and make them never want to leave. You're just going to have to hire more people because they're going to leave, right? And if you don't have a really seamless operational function to make sure that people can focus on the stuff that they care most about, to make sure people are focused on driving the business, you're going to lose some of the value there. So we were really sure that we focus not just on building a great learning organization and focus on just hiring people, but how it all fits together to create a really, really amazing experience for employees. And that's part of our secret, right? And so, again, we're growing really quickly, we're hiring really quickly, and because the company is doing fairly well, the level at which people need to perform continues to raise, right? We continue to raise the bar on performance, and that's really what the effective people function should do. And when you continue to level up, there's a couple ways you can do that, right? You can hire lots of people, which you're doing. You can hire lots and lots of more senior people and keep putting on workers. You can do that. You can fire everyone who started with the company because they can't scale with the business and hire everyone. You could do that. I would recommend it, but you can do it. Or you can take the approach that we've chosen to focus on, which is helping people grow and scale really quickly to make sure that they can match their two organizations growing. So we've done a bunch of stuff in that area, right? So one of the things that we first focused on, and this is one that we part of time and lifelong with, is when we thought about where can we have the biggest impact quickly, and it kind of seems obvious in retrospect, but we know, right, you know, everyone here knows that the biggest impact on an employee's performance is having a really, really good management. There's tons of research to support that. Because we grew so quickly, and in many ways we had a growth from the bottom up, right? So we hired kind of the first line, the second line employees first, and then we hired managers, and we hired directors, and now we're hiring VPs. We had to help make sure that people could scale really quickly. And our first group of managers were all people who'd been with the company since the beginning. They were really, really talented leaders, and they were growing with the company. But there were some basic managerial competencies that they didn't have, and we thought, if we can fix that, if we can address that one area, we can have a huge impact on the rest of the organization, because these are the people that are going to be hiring the next wave of employees, these are the people that are going to be training. And so focusing on that small area can actually have a huge exponential impact across the organization. So that's what we did. So we built this program. We're really big with the clients. We're really big with the app. We created this swim program. Because we're digital illusion, right? And so we created a swim class. So it's great, great marketing work there. And so partnering with Live Labs, we spent a lot of time saying, what are the most important things that we can do to help managers get better quickly? Where can they most move the needle and grow their organizations? And we invested a fair amount of time, between 8 and 12 hours, maybe more, over the course of a couple of months, saying, managers, like, your number one job is to build and grow your teams. Like, that's what a manager is. You're not just a fancy IC doing higher level work. Your job as a manager is to help make your team better. That was an intentional decision we made, and it's had a huge impact. And then we've continued to grow on that. Things like a DigitalOcean University, things like a book club, where one of our founders, who is just incredibly passionate about learning, and he would tell you that everything you need to know, you can get from a book. He sits down once a month and he talks to the organization about his favorite business-related book or psychology-related book, why he likes it, what he got out of it, and we had a discussion about that, right? And so that's cool, right? You actually get to hear directly from one of our founders about what's true with them. But what's even more important, what's even more interesting is creating a culture like that where learning is something that's an investment in time that's appreciated and valued, saying we are going to take time out of hundreds, thousands of things we have to do every day to make sure that people focus on getting better and getting their teams better. That's a really powerful thing to have a founder from do that. And it's had a huge impact, right? So you see kind of what we've been able to do on the hiring side. I'll share some other ways that it's driven. We know that helping people understand where their career is growing, helping people understand how they're going to grow, how they're going to get better in an organization, that's a huge driver of engagement. I'll talk about some of the metrics we have to back it up. It's a huge driver of referrals, which then drives recruiting, right? So it all kind of circles together in a virtuous way. It drives our growth and it drives our retention. So these things, which to some extent can seem like a big investment, we have a big people team for a company our size, I'm happy to say it. But I'm pretty comfortable that the investments pay off in terms of our ability to hire, scale quickly. We're hiring an incredible clip. People are growing to new heights in the organization. Our attrition is in the low single digits. I'm more than happy to have a conversation with my CFO, and I have, on a number of occasions, about why this is an investment worth making. And it's a great, great approach. And we're very lucky to have founders that value their approach. And so one of the things that we continue to build is learning culture, and as we want to make sure that people continue to grow, people continue to develop, people continue to get better, one of the things that's a hallmark of that, which is perfect following Andrew's presentation, is how do we make sure that we're providing people the feedback that they need to get better at what they're doing. And so we've worked really hard to create a process around continuous development, where we're always asking for feedback, we're always looking for what can we do to get better. And so some of the systems and some of the operations we've put in place in partnership with Reflective, right? We actually have a quarterly cycle around goal setting and feedback, right? And this can seem very heavy, it can seem like very operational, but we make sure we do it in a really lightweight. It's really about saying to managers, hey, at a minimum, have a conversation with the people on your team on what's most important to focus on, what are your biggest priorities, what are the goals that you're going to set, and then every quarter have a conversation, well, how are you doing against that? What are you working on that's working? What are you working on that you need to get better? In any kind of rapid growth startup environment, things change so quickly in terms of the prioritization. It's not a yearly cycle, it's not a 6-month cycle, it's barely a quarterly cycle. So it's really important as a business continues to grow and as a business continues to pivot, that you make sure that everyone in your organization understands, well, what do I need to focus on? What should I be doing to help drive it? And how can I have that conversation with the manager? And so a quarterly cycle of goals and feedback, again, it may seem like a lot, but we worked really hard to keep it lightweight, and it's basically have a conversation with your manager on kind of what you're doing and how you want to get better. And so we've really taken the simplest part of it, which is kind of core to our efforts. We've taken the basic fundamentals of feedback and goal setting. We don't do kind of formal ratings anymore. It's really more about how can you capture in a qualitative way just what they're doing, how can you make sure you have a conversation with that. We've disaggregated to a large extent the ratings and the compensation. In large part because we want to encourage people to have really, really candid feedback. And there's tons of research that says when people think their ratings are very closely tied to compensation, they're less likely to give really developmentally focused candid feedback, so we took that away. That doesn't mean that compensation isn't tied to performance, and of course it is, but it's not the only thing, and we really care much more about people having regular candid feedback conversations. And then we use it in a number of ways to drive the organization. We started a biannual cycle of talent planning, which is kind of like two-dimensional performance models. So you talk about where they've done, have they performed in the past quarter or the past year, and where they're going, what's their potential, where can they grow in the organization. Because again, we know that's what people care about, and when you're thinking about growing a business, it's not just enough to know, do you have the right people performing at the right level today? Do you have the right people performing at the right level for the next 3 months, the next 6 months? Can you help people get there? So these are all conversations that we support very deeply from a people perspective. But ultimately, right, we think these are things that managers need to do to help their organization get better. And so these are some of the operations and systems. Again, we continually invest in people's growth from a mentorship perspective, from a feedback perspective, from a growth perspective. And as I said, like we think we have pretty good results to kind of justify this. So it's probably an odd chart for most of you in the organization. The takeaway is we actually, again, we're big on data, we're big on measurement. We actually measure employee engagement on a number of different metrics every 6 months. So you see 2015 and 2016. This is not actually a year ago. These are the increases just over the past 6 months, where, by the way, we've hired half our organization. And on things that we know are the biggest drivers of performance, of engagement, of retention. In just 6 months, we've seen a huge increase because of the investment we've made, helping people get better at what they do, helping managers get better at what they do. We know we've made improvements in our own organization, and where we have external benchmarks, we feel pretty good about kind of where DigitalOcean is from a benchmark perspective. And like I said, we're hiring lots of people, they're still with us, they're happy, they feel connected to the organization, they feel like we're growing, we feel like this approach has worked really well for us. So, I've only been here a year, it feels like longer. But that's because there's so much going on, right? And we're continuing to grow. Like I think back what the organization looked like even a year ago, it's almost unrecognizable kind of what it looks like now. And so when I think about what are we going to do in the next 6 months, what in the next year, kind of what's next for us in a rapidly growing organization. We're growing our leadership team, right? Whenever I say we're building from the bottom up. So that's going to be an interesting process, right? How do we continue to bring in more senior, more external leaders with more experience in a way that feels additive to a culture that believes in the things that we do, that cares about the stuff, so that we continue to kind of keep and maintain what makes DigitalOcean so special. So that's what we're working on. We've done a lot of stuff on kind of the basic foundational building blocks on training managers. Great, we've got most of our managers trained up already. What's the next step for them? How can we help them get better? How can we build our next level of the organization, our next level of leadership? We're going to be rolling out advanced management. Focusing on high potential is not just focusing on people in specific roles, but who are the people that have the impact to be the leaders of tomorrow? What training, what development, what coaching can we give to help them get better, to help them be part of the next organization? Making sure that we expand the channels of feedback, right? We have a lot of kind of top-down feedback, and we're starting to get bottom-up feedback, or how do we incorporate things like 360s, a talent process involving different levels of calibration? How can we make sure that everyone is involved and sharing feedback, and that's just a foundational way that we can do this with IT. And then continuing to recalibrate, we spend a lot of time on classroom-based learning because we're early on, those are things you want to do when you kind of have an early stage organization, but as we get bigger and as there's more experiences for people to do, as we have an opportunity to move people into new roles, as we bring in more senior people that they can learn from, making sure that we have the right blend of experiential versus classroom-based learning is going to be really, really critical for us. That is presentation. It's been a great story. Like I said, I've only been here a year, but it's been an amazing organization. I'm super lucky to have a founding team that will be doing stuff. I'm incredibly lucky to have an amazing people team that works in this every day. It's been a great journey.